Hello, and welcome to The Reactor. Alright, so here we're going to get to Cog. No other way. This was a recommendation from one of you out there. So keep on doing that, so we can keep on finding great music to listen to. I think you said we're from Australia, so that's awesome. Let's see what this is all about, eh? It's like Canadian, Australian, something. Canadian. Can't even talk. Americanian. Here we go. Cheers. Tea time. Changing gears here, maybe. So this beginning part is—it's just gives you such a beautiful soundscape, and a vision. It just reminds me. It's got this. I'm trying to put my finger on it, but it's got this classic feel to it. I feel like I'm just in an open field, somewhere, just dreaming about something and watching the clouds go by, and it just has this. It's like Pink Floyd-ish. It reminds me a lot of Pink Floyd in some of their acoustic tunes. It has that classic feel to it, but with a little bit of something new added. Can't quite put my finger on it yet, but there is some really cool aspects to this song already. Great intro, nice and smooth, really clean, and just giving you this nice open space to just chill out in. All right, here we go. Ordered by a God above. Ah, so clean.
Now
back to that. That's a nice punch, I guess, and just jamming right into that new rhythm. So these guys are really dynamic. I mean, they're doing a lot of different things. I mean, the things that came to my mind was like Pink Floyd at first because of the different soundscapes and things that Pink Floyd does with acoustics. And then Red Hot Chili Peppers came in because they're kind of like a pop funk kind of thing. And some just all these different rhythms and different soundscapes that just keep happening. It's crazy. Now the drummer, I don't know if he's like really jazzy influenced. There are some things, I don't know if he does the, the way they hold, you know, how jazz drummers hold their, that stick on one hand. It sounds like he's a jazz drummer. And just so clean. I mean, jazz drummers are just known to be super crisp and super clean. And this is definitely in that realm. It's just something that I love when I hear certain drum beats. It's so crispy and just has that nice, beautiful, high-pitched tone in the rolls. Now, the voice, too, is another piece that something it's unique, but it matches the drum style, which is interesting, at least in my brain, because the guitars and the bass are kind of doing their own thing, but the vocalist and the drummer are kind of, I think, have an interesting relationship here. They have that, I don't know if they're on the same wavelength or what, I don't know. That's just what happens when I listen to music. My brain just goes off in weird places. All right, so here we go with a different transition. So, yeah, in that section there, the drummer and the vocalist were both really just hammering it out and it panning in different ears, which made it, like, wild. And now we're getting into something even more different. This is just wild stuff.
To show.
That is some heavy stuff. And it's, I mean, not like heavy, but like, because their sound is, it's like hard rock sound. Their distortion levels and everything, they had some punch, but they weren't like overdone like some like heavy metal bands. So I would consider this to be like, I don't even know, because there's so much going on. It's so well written. The chord structures that they're using with the guitars and some of the clean spots, there's some really, I would love to see the key tabs for this, because it sounds to me like it's pretty complicated and not just strums. You know, there are some pretty stretched finger style chord structures going on there. And and it's so, I guess, yeah, it's just, there's so many different bands that come to mind when I hear this. Like, there's a little bit of Tool in there, and there's a little bit of pop and funk and Rage Against the Machine, and there's so many things like that come to my mind when I listen to this whole thing. So they're utilizing a lot of aspects of a lot of different genres and just going to town. These guys really know their stuff. Very unique sound, super clean and super crispy. It's and on top of that, it has a, like a almost like a clean, dirty distortion, if that makes sense, with the guitars. The bass lines were just smooth as glass, and again, the drumming is just, I think, is just phenomenal. I'd love to see him just play the drums. So if you do know of some other videos of these guys, I'd love to see him play live or what have you. Just really super dynamic stuff. I'm just trying to go back into my brain, because there were so many like rhythm changes and things that were happening. But the beautiful soundscape, like every instrument was just had open air. It had an open space to play. But it all came together and just kind of reminded me of just, where it began, like you're out in the field and just watching the clouds go by, but then there's some tension in there. And then that buildup that was happening toward the end, it was slowly building up and you knew something was coming, and they hit that pinnacle, and then it just kind of, you know, it didn't escalate into this giant eruption. It hit a high point and then it just kind of rode off with that. So really interesting the way they put this soundscape together, the sound structures, the chord structures, the composition of everything is brilliant. So awesome stuff. Cog really takes the cake of just making my brain go into all these different places, trying to follow along with them, trying to listen to each instrument, and really just gave my fed my brain. I think I'm full. All right, so that was Cog, No Other Way. And if you do know of this band or know more of them, other tunes like them, please do comment, and we'll keep the music thing flowing. Alrighty, folks, until the next time. Cheerio.